with a potential of 12 points. Now a fight breaks out. Strudwick got rocked there big time by Matt Walker. I think Strudwick's in that hold on vein. I just turned my head and somebody got clobbered, and I believe Walker caught Strudwick. And the crowd on their feet here at Savage Center. And Strudwick, since very early, has not been able to do anything.
Now, Matt Walker's a big kid and has been excited to get back in the lineup, and you can see what his job is. He's a physical defenseman, and he comes right into the thick of things. Strudwick's not going to back down, and that's a great effort. And that, look at the crowd. That's really wound up this crowd, and that's got to add some excitement to that Blues bench, because the Blues have not had a good start to this game, and maybe that'll turn it around. Here's on the wide. You see, there's the hit there. Strudwick right on Walker, and the two of them just dropped their gloves right away and wanted to dance. And you can see Strudwick did try to get a punch in there, but he couldn't reach Walker.
He got a good right hand. Walker did. He didn't get a look at it there. But, I mean, he creamed him with a right hand, and Strudwick was really done. But he was valiant. He hung in there but couldn't do much after getting spots on the chin. A 5-on-3 for well over a minute. Mellenby, Tkachuk, Dimitra, Waite, and this man, Pronger. 5-on-3, right through the slot. Mellenby hits the side of the net. Now Pronger at the right point, right below us, with the puck. Shots are 4-2 Chicago. The puck tipped away from Mellenby. McLean can't clear. Here's Tkachuk. Over to Dimitra. Now to Pronger. Over to Waite. To Mellenby. Back for Waite. To Mellenby. 5-on-3, you always want to get the perfect shot idea. Here's Dimitri, he shoots, and a dandy glove save by Jocelyn Thibault.
Good save there, and there, unfortunately, Pavel Dimitri couldn't get that up high enough. But a good chance right off the first opportunity, but you see here, Dimitri tries to go across to Mellenby, and Mellenby with a good opportunity, but he just hit the side of the net. But I'd still like to see Pavel Dimitri move once he gets that puck, take a step towards the net.
Another 33 seconds to go in the 5-on-3. Berard stripped of the puck by Dimitra. Back to Pronger. He's got time. Over to Waite. Now Sillinger out there in Mellenby's spot. Sillinger has the puck poked away by Berard, who's out with Hops and Bell. They don't seem to shoot much on a 5-on-3. There's a shot that deflects and hits the side of the helmet of Sillinger. In front, Tkachuk, and he's poke checked. He wants the puck. Boy, late call. Christian Beckman getting around Eric Nicholas. Just flips the puck into the corner. Waite is beat to it by Bell. They bump a little bit. Mellenby comes blasting his way in. Waite in front, and the tip stop. Then a shot, and they score!
Sure that one of the Hawks may have kicked this in, Kenny, because that puck was going wide. We'll maybe get a look at it from the overhead, because I could not tell from this angle how that puck ended going in. But here's the play from Waite. You see here how just the reach out there by Mellenby. Oh, that's what exactly it was, kicked in, I believe, there by the defenseman, I think, right there. And it went across. You can see it did go all the way across. Here's the overhead look. But watch how it goes, I believe, off the skate there of Vandermeer. There it is. And he actually kicked it in. So the goal will be credited to Scott Mellenby.
The Blues take the lead 1-0.
And finally on the power play, he will go.
Here's Dimitra to Tkachuk, but he's well covered by Pops. The penalty just about over. Over to Weinrich, to Tkachuk. He shoots and scores! Oh, baby! What a pass and what a shot! And the Blues take the lead 2-0.
Well, it's not going to be considered a power play goal because Quinn had just come out of the box, but a beautiful play. Keith Tkachuk isolated right into the middle of the slot. Was able to take the pass. Great play by Weinrich. And look at no one around Tkachuk. And the upstairs shot, as we talked about, Kivo goes down and shoot it high. And that's exactly what Tkachuk did there. Beautiful goal. The Blues take a 2-0
lead. Arneson. Now Berard gives Arneson the puck again. Barron and Weinrich. Good play there by Osgood. And Chianik killing the penalty. Berard keeps the puck into Vandermeer. Still 1:05 to go in the two-man advantage. Good block by Chianik. Vandermeer is shot. That goes wide, and Osgood reaches out and tips the puck to the corner. Played into the middle by Weinrich and shot down the ice by Chianik. 50 seconds until Walker's back. And
good play by Chris Osgood. You heard Kenny mention it. As a lot of times a 5-on-3, you need the goaltender to cut off the passes that come through the crease or towards the crease and to the player on the far side. You see how Osgood makes the play here. You see the pass trying to come across there. A nice play with his blocker there as he deflected that out from the danger area.
Weinrich trying to clear. Tough, of course, to be down like this as the puck comes in front, and they score! Deflected, and the youngster, Matt Keith, in just his 15th NHL game, gets the goal, and that's his second.
Just a shot, a harmless-looking shot. The Hawks just trying to shoot the puck towards the net. And Keith, a big kid, parked himself in front. You see how the puck just bounced through, and Keith just got a piece of it enough to hit Osgood first and then bounce through. But here's a look at it. You see how it just hit Osgood up on the stick and then just caromed off him inside the net. So the Hawks cut the lead 2-1. They still have 41 seconds to the power play on the call against Chris Pronger.
So a huge lift for the Blackhawks. Now down only 2-1. Varinka, and he'll clear it out. Here's Pronger. Out there was Salvador. Head down to Tkachuk, a breakaway for Dimitra. He's in on Tebow. He shoots. He scores! Big goal! That makes it 3-1. A breakaway goal for Pavel Dimitra. And that one is number 23 for the Slovakian. And the Blues with that two-goal margin.
Great play to Dimitra, but a huge mistake by the Hawks. They got caught on a line change. And the pass, Tkachuk. Look at Dimitra all alone in front of the Blues bench, and he walked right in, beat Tebow to the far side. Beautiful shot, great play, and the Blues regain their two-goal lead.
Now from the faceoff, the Hawks get the puck in, Osgood up the boards, and Mellanby clears the zone. Blues, Mellanby to Drake, to Wake, he shoots. That goes off McCarthy. Wake gets the puck from Drake again, over to Mellanby. Mellanby will shoot. He scores! He parachutes one in. Oh, the Hawks are screaming. The Hawks are going high stick. And the referees are going to consult here.
Well, I'm not surprised that they didn't see it. But they will go upstairs here. That the puck was hit with a stick. But I don't know who hit it. I don't know if it was one of the Blues or who it was. But here's a look at it. The puck is elevated, and it hit something and went down. Now, did it hit somebody? Did it hit? Let's take a look here from this angle. And that's Doug Waite's stick. That's no goal, folks.
Cannot be over the crossbar. The stick cannot be over the crossbar. And I would agree that's no goal.
Yep. That's no goal. But if we get another look at it, guys, you see Scott Mellanby looking on. But here it is, folks. This is Doug Waite. Watch his stick goes way up in the air there and makes contact with it. And then it goes right down in between the legs of Tebow. That's good. Now, were they not watching me draw on the telestrator here, Kenny? I explained it perfectly. I even showed exactly where it got hit, and I showed exactly where it went between his legs.
I don't think they pay attention to us, Bernie.
And Doug Waite right now, I'm talking to one of the referees. And I think he's saying that, yeah, it was pretty high. You can see his lips is pretty high. I think maybe I hit it with a high stick, but I'm not sure. Never give it away, just in case they don't see it. Tebow is for sure. But here it is. Let's see from the overhead. Look there. You can see how high his stick was when he made contact with that.
There's no question.
Yeah. That looked like a parachute pass, but it ended up with a sinker ball on it as it was hit by the high stick.
Melanby fading away. Had that baby just sort of floating to the net, and it parachuted down thanks to Doug Waite's stick.
So now we're getting into basketball terms now, huh?
Yeah.
Fadeaway jumper.
Yeah.
Seeing that it's.
You don't see players drift back 10, 15 feet like that in hockey, Bernie, and take a shot very often. That might be a first.
Okay, folks, here's the freeze, but you can see his stick up in the air. And there it is as it comes down and in between the legs. And what is taking this so long? Kenny, what takes so long?
I have no idea.
Please.
No goal. No goal.
Upon video review, there was no goal because the puck was struck by a high stick prior to the goal.
They got the same looks and we can't speak of it more.
I hope they didn't have to call Toronto on that one. Route 2 steals the puck. Route 2, a shot. He scores! So instead of being 4-1 Blues, it's 3-2 Blues.
At the beginning of the season, Kenny, I think when we went to Chicago the first time, we talked about this kid right here, Rutu, that everybody was projecting that he may be the Calder Trophy winner as the NHL's top rookie. And he really had a slow start. But look at this, this is his 19th goal. And here's a kid with great skills. He's big, he's strong. And what a play here, and a quick shot up underneath the crossbar. And his 19th cuts the lead to 3-2. And he went a lot of games without scoring, and now in the last
game, Kenny.
Well, you can't emphasize the importance. Be nice to get a goal, make it 4-2, and put an end to it. But it's not that easy sometimes, and they score just like that. It's 3-3. Darren Quick blasts it home off the iron. And the Blues, who have seemingly spent most of the game ahead by two goals, now see the game tied 3-3, a game they must win.
Yeah, you can just see the look on the face of Mike Kitchen as, again, just a weird play. You see the puck bent over, just ricocheted, and Quick came up from the point and just blasted that right off the iron, as you said, Kenny, right underneath the crossbar. In fact, it hit the crossbar and then went down in. In fact, the corner of the post and crossbar.
Ahead to Sillinger, nicely. To Chiantic, trying to get through, he can't. Now Weinrich will get the puck. Gives it to Sillinger, back to Weinrich. Gives you an idea what the Blues do in overtime. The shot stopped, Weinrich shoots, puck in the air, drops in the crease. Hawks have it, lose it, Salvador shot, they score! Salvador.
How important is that goal? Bryce Salvador, that's his second overtime goal this season, but a huge mistake by the Hawks in their own zone, and traffic in front, and Salvador just took a shot to the net that ended up going in. But you'll see right here, the puck is going to bounce loose, and Berard has it instead of trying to clear it. Watch, he gets it stolen from him, and just this simple shot there, the deflection there, I don't know, Peter, whoever it was, Peter China may have tried to deflect it right in front, but here it is. Let's see if it was touched. But it did go in, and the Blues, a huge victory, Kenny, and the Blues now in that actually tied for seventh as that puck actually hit the arm there of Tebow and then went in. And a hugest, I guess, win that we can talk about right now is right here again, Kenny, is that we... This is getting redundant. We say this every time the Blues win a game, how important it is. But once again, this is The biggest win of the season.
An explosion on the bench. And the crowd leaping to their feet. Almost 20,000. A memorable finish. Whoa. The Blues get the two they had to have, and they'll play Chicago at 3 o'clock tomorrow afternoon at United Center. For Dan McLaughlin and Bernie Federico, I'm Ken Wilson. Thanks for joining us. The Blues win it in overtime, 4-3. Our next telecast Tuesday night, 6:30 on Fox Sports Net. And remember, next Saturday afternoon back on WB11 in Nashville. Thanks for joining us. The final again in OT, 4-3 Blues.